Hello, PWAY. I'm Chayne.
And I'm Savion, welcoming you to another episode of Life in Black and Gold.
Hey, Savion, what'd you do for Halloween?
I ate way too much candy and got the worst stomach ache of my life.
That's rough. Well, I went to Haunted High, and it was amazing. Just in case you missed it, here's some clips.
Recently, Piscataway High School held its annual Haunted High. So many clubs came out to show off their finest skills and scare little children. After hours of preparation, the frights were ready to begin.
Contains a number and a riddle. You have to find three numbers to fill these three spots. Once you fill up those three spots, you'll be able to get out of here by opening this and getting the key. Guys, ready?
Now here's Chris with the sports update.
As always, Piscataway reigns supreme in the sports world. If you missed out, we got you covered.
Congrats to the Lady Chiefs as they defeated Franklin on October 18th. Dominique Nelson scored two goals, helping the Chiefs win 4-0. The seniors honored were Julie Baker, Kamira Brunson, Mayjoy Duwana, Kayla Gray, Sajana Sugamaran, and Amber Tuck. Thank you, ladies, for your commitment to the sport. Good luck in your futures.
On October 20th, the Piscataway Chiefs football team played their last home game against the Monroe Falcons. The Chiefs won the game 48-21. Before the game started, Piscataway honored the seniors of the Super Chiefs Marching Band, the Piscataway Cheer Team, and the football team. We wish these seniors good luck after their high school careers.
I think I'm gonna miss playing with my teammates. You know, we've come to bond as a family. We've been playing together since freshman year, so I mean, it's like it doesn't get better than that.
I was uptight, wanna let loose. I was dreaming of bigger things and wanna leave my old life.
The boys' soccer team fought really hard in their win against Perth Amboy.
The mode, have a seat in the foyer, take a number. I was lightning before the thunder.
Thunder, 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 thunder,
thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder, thunder,
thunder, feel the thunder.
Scoring a total of 7 points in the game. Good job, boys. Keep up the great work.
They say you're basic.
I was riding in the back.
How do you think the team did during this meet?
I was very pleased with the way we ran. The seniors especially started the race running together. They were excited. It was their last home dual meet. It's a special group of seniors. There's 11 seniors that have given a lot of time. Most of them run three seasons for us. They run winter, spring track, and cross country. They've committed a lot of time, given up a lot, and they're great teammates. They're great students, and they're just a pleasure to coach. And I thought they did a really good job today. So we're real pleased with their performance, and I wish them nothing but best of luck in the next couple of meets, which are the big meets, the county meet, the GMC meet, and the state sectional meet. So we're real happy for them, and we're going to enjoy the last 3 to 4 weeks of the season.
So it's who I spend most of my time with.
Major meets happening in a couple of weeks. We wish them all the best of luck, as well as the graduating seniors with the last few races of their high school career.
October 18th was gymnastics senior night. They won against Dayton High School 100.125 to 97.2. Our senior Sydney Thompson competed all around with scores as follows. Our other senior, Troy Marshall, also competed all around with scores as follows. Our third senior, Nadia Watson, was unable to compete, but was there to support with the rest of the team. Congratulations to all three of our seniors, Sydney, Troy, and Nadia, and good job to the whole team.
Of course, PWAY has a lot to offer besides just sports. We also have many clubs that just don't get enough recognition, so they've asked us to make them some commercials.
What Chinese Culture Club has to offer is a great space to learn about Chinese culture in all different aspects.
So I joined Chinese Culture Club so I could understand the culture better because I'm Chinese and I don't really know a lot about my own culture, so I thought it would be a great way to learn more about it.
Somebody should join Chinese Culture Club because we are a welcoming space of everyone and to learn about all the things you need to know about Chinese culture.
You would learn of what Chinese lifestyle would be like. Like today, we learned about Chinese wedding.
Calligraphy, books, we got fashion, and food. Chinese Culture Club meetings are held on Fridays in room D274 from 2 to 3.
If you're interested in having your club put in the spotlight, email us at pwaytv@pway.org with information about your club, and we will produce a short video spot just for you. Now, onto our chief spotlight, which features a student who is the CEO and designer of his own clothing business, Denzel Cuffy.
What's up? It's your boy King Flexin' One Time. Today, I'm here with Denzel Cuffy, the owner of Devious Clothing. Thank you for joining us today.
No problem, man.
All right, so the first question I have for you today is, what is Devious Clothing?
Devious Clothing is just a lifestyle brand where basically you can just wear it every day, doing anything.
Are there any fan favorites that people like the most?
The favorite was the burgundy tee. It was like inspired by Supreme a little bit. It was basically just a box logo with like surrounded with devious lettering and had like a Chinese symbol in the middle.
So where do you see this company going in the future? Like after you graduate, do you plan on continuing it?
Yeah, I want to grow it as much as I can, like surpass like basically every company that's out right now. I just want to blow it up and make it as big as possible.
All right, so the last question I have for you is, what do you have to say to like all the youngins out there that want to do what you're doing right now?
Basically, just have a positive mentality, like totally immerse yourself in like the lifestyle and like the things that you want. Like just act like it's already yours. And like, I feel like it'll come to you eventually.
All right, thank you. Today I'm here with Denzel Cuffy, and see you next time on Chief Spotlight.
And that concludes this episode of Life in Black and Gold.
And don't forget to order your yearbook soon. The price goes up December 1st.
You can order them at www.balfour.com.
I'm Savion.
And I'm Chayne. Stay golden, PUA.